Hello viewers, in this video we are going to discuss the basic terms in database systems such as database, database management system and advantages of DBMS. Let's first see what is in by database. A database is a collection of data that describes the activities of one or more related organizations. For example, if we take a university database, it might contain information about the entities such as students, faculty and courses, and the relationship between them also can be stored into the database. Here, entities are nothing but the real world objects, either that has to physically or conceptually exist, and they are distinguishable from other objects. Here, when we take the entities students and courses, a student entity is related into a course entity only when he enrolled into the course. Very similarly, a faculty is related into a course entity when he teaches that particular course. So, the relationship between the students and courses is enrollment, and the relationship between the faculty and courses is teaching. So these relationship can be stored into the database in addition to the entities. Here, as shown in this figure, usually databases are represented in cylindrical shape. Let's now discuss what is in the database management system. A database management system is a software designed to assist in maintaining and utilizing large collections of data. It is used for storing and retrieving the data effectively whenever required. Apart from efficient storage and retrieval of data, it also provides proper security measures for protecting the data from unauthorized access and system crash. In database management system, SQL queries and relational algebraic query languages are used to fetch the data stored in database. Now let's see the advantages of a DBMS. Data independence, efficient data access, data integrity and security, data administration, concurrent access and crash recovery, reduced application development time. These are the advantages that can be achieved through DBMS. Now let's see the advantages briefly one by one. First one, data independence. Data independence is nothing but the ability to modify a schema definition in one level of a DBMS structure without affecting the schema definition in the next higher level of DBMS. DBMS achieves this data independence by providing an abstract view of the data to the higher level users. Next one is efficient data access. A DBMS achieves the efficient data access by utilizing a variety of sophisticated techniques. Next one is data integrity and security. DBMS achieves data integrity by defining constraints on the data before being accessed. Also, it achieves security on data by defining access controls in order to govern what data is visible to which classes of users. So next advantage is data administration. DBMS effectively performs centralized data administration when it is accessed and shared by multiple users. Next one is concurrent access and crash recovery. Concurrent access means many users can access the data at the same time. So this concurrent access can be efficiently achieved in DBMS. DBMS also protects and recovers data even in case of a system failure and crash in the system. Next one is reduced application development time. This can be achieved because DBMS supports many important functions that are common to many applications which are accessing data stored in a database management system. That's why it is possible to develop applications in less time. So these are the advantages of DBMS. Viewers, in this video we have learnt about database management systems and its advantages.